Brunt Showdown at Shea. The fabulous Moolah and Beverly Slade take on Kandi Malloy and Peggy Lee. No, not the singer, but the wrestler, Peggy Lee.
This special ladies tag team match to be 1-4, 20-minute time limit. Introducing the principals from Chicago, Illinois, at a weight of 140 pounds, Miss Peggy Lee. Her tag team partner, 129 pounds, from Greenville, South Carolina, Kandi Malloy. And their opponents, 142 pounds, from Kansas City, Kansas, Beverly Slade. Tag team partner, the world famous women's champion from South Carolina, 143 pounds, the fabulous Moolah.
I'm surprised you don't have any poems worked up for the divas of yesteryear.
Oh, give me a chance here, Michael. Give me a chance. I was wondering if that Peggy Lee was any relation to Peggy Lee Leather, who I wrestled with overseas on several occasions, and that indeed is the young lady there, Peggy Lee, who would become Peggy Lee Leather, who was on that Burkina Faso tour I alluded to earlier.
Really?
Yes, yeah. Yeah, so it's kind of neat.
This is like the second version of, instead of, this is, what was it, Rock, This Is Your Life for the Rock,
this is,
right?
This is like
This Is Your Life, Mick.
Yeah, because I get to see Captain Lou Albano, who just celebrated his 77th birthday, who I knew when I broke in. Peggy Lee Leather, who actually gave me a neck massage when Power Udi, the Nigerian champion, dropped me on my head. This is bringing back some good memories for me.
And, of course, probably the most famous women's champion of all time, one of the nicest women you would have ever met, the fabulous Moolah, who passed away just last year, November 2007, at the age of 84. Mick, Moolah at this point in time of this matchup was in the midst of an historic run as women's champion. She held the title from 1956 to 1984.
That's a phenomenal run on top, as they say. And you point out what a nice woman fabulous Moolah was, but that was a well-kept secret back in these days, because she did not appear to be nice to any of our great fans.
And we talked earlier about the changing of the guard from Backlund to Sheik to Hogan, and this was just a few years before the changing of the guard from a Moolah to Wendy Richter, who she would lose the title to, again back in that rock and wrestling era.
And then, of course, Moolah as the Spider recapturing the women's championship in a match that has taken on a life of its own, because Wendy Richter apparently was so dissatisfied with the outcome that she more or less retreated from the world of wrestling forever.
For you history buffs, Moolah would be a part of the first ever Shea Stadium Super Show. It was held in September 1972 when she would successfully defend her title against Debbie Johnson.
You know, I'm going to come up with a little song for Peggy Lee there. It was like this, Peggy Lee, Peggy Lee. Pretty, pretty, pretty little Peggy Lee, my Peggy.
Isn't it actually Peggy Sue? Oh, you're just changing the words for your
purposes. No, I was under the impression that I was creating magic as we spoke, not plagiarizing.
Just like these forerunners of today's divas are creating magic in the ring in this tag team matchup. But again, Mick, how things have changed. I mean, back here in 1980, women's wrestling so different than what it is today.
Well, so many of the precursors to the divas that we would have seen in this era would have been trained by Moolah in South Carolina, and for better or worse, they all had a similar style. It wouldn't be until years later that fans would be exposed to ladies who were trained in other parts of the country, other parts of the world, including very well kept secret. I had a girlfriend many, many years ago who had been trained and wrestled around the world, and I've never revealed her name. It's up to people to research that if they want. But she incorporated a variety of different styles, and really, believe it or not, taught me a lot about technical wrestling, which I proceeded to ignore.
Fabulous Moolah was such a trailblazer, made history in so many different ways. You realize she was the first woman to ever wrestle at Madison Square Garden, because women were banned from competing there until after 1972.
Yeah, so Moolah, in a sense, was like the Rosa Parks of the women's wrestling movement. Maybe not to that extent, but certainly a historical figure.
Moolah, of course, was the first woman inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame, a tremendous honor for her as well.
You know, at this point, clearly, you know, Moolah was not at the peak of her physical prowess, but look at the way she kind of commands attention and really enjoyed the, absorbing the boos of the fans. She wasn't someone who was secretly looking for cheers like so many of today's mat villains.
Well, when Moolah began her career, she was one of the first female valets ever, Slave Girl Moolah. Now, Nick, this was back in a time where women weren't allowed around wrestling at all. People didn't want anything to do with them. It was a man's sport.
I'm just looking at the proceedings here, starting to get out of hand. You see, the one-piece bathing suit was the outfit of choice. It's just indicative of how much things have changed.
The double team by Moolah and Beverly Slade.
And Kandi Malloy really taking a beating in the hands of Moolah, really working out that tag team rope, much to the chagrin of Kandi Malloy.
A lot more leeway allowed by the officials.
Oh, no doubt about it. I'll tell you what, that Billy Caputo is no referee Charles Robinson.
Wasn't there a ring announcer named Caputo?
And Kandi Malloy makes a hot tag, and in comes a pre back of the bus for Kino Faso.
That was Gary Capetta.
Neck massaging Peggy Lee.
Oh, the monkey flip.
Hammering Beverly with some forearms to the upper pectoralis, and in comes the Moolah.
Notice how Beverly used that athleticism to make her way to the corner to make the tag. And Moolah is in trouble. Moolah is in a world of trouble as these 36,000 in attendance at the final showdown at Shea Show begin to murmur with excitement.
This was the final wrestling spectacular at Shea Stadium. Am I correct?
Yes.
So this is somewhat akin to the final Billy Joel concert at Shea, or the final Mets game ever at Shea.
Yes. You've never wrestled at Shea.
I never had the chance to wrestle at Shea.
Would have been great, though. Quick drive home for you.
Good drive home for me.
Now look at the double team, and oh!
Did you just say, oh?
Moolah and Slade are in a world of trouble.
Why does the guy in the cowboy hat get such a good ringside seat? Peggy Lee missing with a big dive, and you got to believe Moolah is going to capitalize, as she does with a big drop kick. Peggy Lee's team's trying to go to that drop kick well, and it's dry.
Fabulous Moolah, so flexible. Look at that. Big back body drop, cover by Moolah, who gets her. And Moolah and Slade with the win at Shea.
The women's world champion picking up.
That match was akin to Willie Mays' final at bat, Game 7 of the 1973 World Series, when he hobbled down to first base after drawing a walk against the Oakland Athletics.
The time of the match, 6 minutes, 18 seconds, and the winners, Miss Beverly Slade and the fabulous Moolah.
And again, another great performance, an extraordinary performance by Moolah.